Hey guys, what's up? This is Nainya from Tech Barrack Solutions, and today we are starting up with Linux tutorials. We will talk about Linux right from scratch, and in this first tutorial, I will give an introduction to Linux. So let's proceed. What is Linux? Linux is an operating system just like Windows and Mac OS X. Linux derives many things from Unix operating system. Linux is open source and free. What does open source and free mean? Let's have a look. Free basically means that no payments are required and you can directly download the Linux operating system and install it on your personal computer. Open source means that there is a source code related to Linux and you can call this source code as the Linux source code, and this source code can be used by any person in the world to create his own operating system. Now the operating system that is created using this Linux source code will be nothing but the Linux operating system. Now because Linux is open source, we have large number of Linux operating systems out there in the market. Let's have a look at the hardware requirements of Linux operating system. I will not go into the specific hardware requirements like how much RAM is required or how much space is required, because every Linux distribution has different hardware requirements. What I'm going to show you is the basic hardware requirement, and that is Linux can be made to run on any x86 or x64 based personal computer. x86 is 32-bit and x64 is 64-bit. Who uses Linux? Linux is mainly used in supercomputers, servers, and Android powered devices. Supercomputers are the fastest computers in the world. They can do large number of arithmetic calculations in a single second. 90% of the fastest 500 supercomputers use Linux. That gives us a hint that Linux is the fastest operating system. Now servers is like a storage, and in servers, website owners store all their website data, SQL databases, Oracle databases, etc., etc. And according to a survey, approximately 60% of servers use Linux and only like 40% use Windows. So Linux is dominating in the server area, and we also have Android powered devices. Now Android powered devices also make use of Linux, and Android powered devices, or you could say the Android operating system, is the most famous mobile operating system and the most widespread mobile operating system today in this era. What is the usage share of Linux? If we have a look at the Wikimedia statistics for June 2012, it says that Linux is being used only by 1.53% and Android is being used by 4.73%. We all know that Android is leading in the mobile market space, but Linux in the desktop, or you could say the personal computer market space, is lagging. And that is because 4-5 years ago, Linux was like you had to code in Linux to do every specific task. Today, Linux has been evolved to graphical user interface. So expect that Linux market share increases. Now the second reason why Linux is lagging is because it does not have great applications. Most of the applications are open source, and I'm not saying that open source applications are bad. I myself use open source applications because they are free. But the problem with open source softwares is that sometimes they lack many things. So you require paid softwares, and one of the best example is Adobe Photoshop. Now, Adobe Photoshop is a paid software available for Windows and Mac OS X. It is not available for Linux. The Linux version is GIMP. It is an open source version. It has the same functions as Adobe Photoshop. But still, users have said that Adobe Photoshop still is better than GIMP. So there might be some areas where Adobe Photoshop is better. So we expect that Linux should get these kind of applications very soon. And if it gets that, then its market share will again boost up. And it also lacks in games. So again, Linux needs some great games and if these games come, then again market share of Linux will boost up. So keeping the market share aside, let's talk about the file system of Linux. Linux makes use of extended journaling file system, that is EXT4, EXT3 and EXT2. EXT4 is currently being used and it supports, that is EXT4 extended journaling file system supports storage volumes up to 2^60 bytes, and that's very large. You can Google it up and you will actually find that that's GBs and GBs and GBs. An extended journaling file system, that is EXT4, has got faster file scanning. So pretty much overall extended journaling file system is really good. Now, what are the famous Linux graphical user interfaces? And I'm talking about famous. There are many graphical user interfaces in Linux. I'm just talking about the famous four. One is GNOME, second is KDE Plasma Desktop, third is XFCE, and fourth is LXDE. Now, GNOME can be further given more graphical user interface using GNOME Shell and Ubuntu Unity. Let's have a look at these famous graphical user interfaces. Let's have a look at GNOME. On the left hand side, we have Ubuntu Unity, and on the right hand side, we have GNOME Shell. So this is how it looks in the GNOME graphical user interface. For KDE Plasma Desktop, it will look like this. And for XFCE and LXDE, it will look like this. The XFCE is on the left hand side and LXDE is on the right hand side. Now let's talk about the home folder in Linux. Now whenever you install Linux operating system, you will have a home folder. Now home folder will contain all your documents, music, videos, etc., etc. Now what comes with the Linux OS? Every Linux distribution comes with basic required software like photo viewer, video player, documents editor, text editor, web browser, mail client, and few games and many other applications which are required for daily usage. Now many Linux distribution also comes with programming languages installed, and they may include PHP, Java, C, C++, etc., etc. So that's what comes with Linux operating systems. Now, what about programming applications in Linux? You can use various programming languages like C, C++, Java, Fortran, etc., etc. to make applications on Linux. Now what about the applications? How do you install them? Now many Linux distribution have their own app store, just like the Mac app store, and users can download the applications from their app store. Applications can also be installed from internet too. Executable file of every Linux distribution is different. Ubuntu's executable file is .deb, so you can install files through .deb also. Or you could say you can install applications using the .deb executable file. And many applications have... What about uninstalling the application? Application uninstalling is done using the terminal or the app store or the executable file itself. Now what about the terminal? What is terminal? Terminal is like the command prompt of Windows, and it is used to perform various tasks like pinging, finding IP addresses of your internet connection, installing applications, doing SSH, etc., etc. So that is the end of this Linux introduction, and I hope you liked it. Please rate, comment, subscribe, and visit techbarrack.com, and also visit the links given on your screen.